very important video for the upcoming FMGE, INICET and NEET. Hit that like button if you too want this to happen. So NB pattern MCQs, if you have any doubts, you can ask me in that WhatsApp number. So there were 8 MCQs which were purely from dermatology, and rest of the other questions I will just tell the answers. So the simple analysis is NEET is the new INICET, so read very carefully and also in depth. So this was the first question, patient coming with multiple fluid filled lesions around the lips, and Zhang smear is showing multinucleated germ cells, and also there were inclusion bodies. What is the most likely causative agent? It is oro-label herpes, so organism is going to herpes simplex viral infection. So this is the clinical picture if they would have given the image, and these are the multinucleated germ cells. So next question says, farmer with slowly progressive irregular swelling is there, sinuses are there, granules are there. If you remember, there is a triad of GST. If you remember our story with RGV, you know that the diagnosis is mycetoma, and specifically it is black granule. So the diagnosis is eumycetoma. And what is it being asked? Most likely observed finding on the KOH. So please remember, students, it is going to be option D, septate hyphae 4 to 5 microns in the width. So as you can see here from this table of Cerebellum Academy notebook. Next is this question. Yeah, indurated plaque with central atrophy or scarring, whatever it is, on the cheek, and chest x-ray showing apical calcifications, and examiner is asking you basically what is a confirmatory test. So with the clinical picture and the clues, buzzword, you might have thought of lupus vulgaris. First step is successfully cleared. The next step is the test to confirm the tuberculosis. Remember, dear students, yes, we can rule out slit skin smear, probe test. They are not useful in the cutaneous tuberculosis, or for that matter, any tuberculosis. So remember, MAN2 test is not going to confirm the diagnosis of tuberculosis. So best option here would have been biopsy, but that was not there in the option. So next best is going to be the polymerase chain reaction. As you can see, this is taken from the Rook's textbook. So you can see BCR has been confirmed the diagnosis of lupus vulgaris. Okay, next is this question, which is a repeat question, PYQ. Pruritic papillovesicular rash over the extensor surfaces, gluten sensitive enteropathy, or celiac sprue, celiac disease, whatever it is, bro, I hope you remember that. Biopsy is showing direct nail fluorescence, IgA in a granular deposition. So very, very straightforward answer is dermatitis herpetiformis. Very simple question. Next question, persistent white reticulated oral mucosal lesions in 6 months, burning sensation on spicy food intake, bilateral white lacy lesions or reticulate pattern or Wickham stries, what is mentioned? So first step is diagnosis. So you have diagnosed it as oral lichen planus most likely. Next step is, what is that medication most likely responsible? Remember, dear students, among the given options, both lithium as well as beta blockers are associated with lichen planus, but beta blockers are more important. As you can see from this table, this is from Bologna. You can clearly see lichen or drug eruptions, you antihypertensive medication. So these are the labetalol and propranolol, which are kept under bold, and you can see here lithium is also there, but lithium is not in the bold, and in this table bold is equal to more important causes for lichen planus or lichen or drug eruptions. So next question, so dark non-itch hyperkeratotic papules in a child with elbows having the predominant side, and there is also some other vitamin deficiency like picture. So most appropriate next step, I hope all of you have diagnosed it as a case of phrenoderma, which is commonly due to vitamin A deficiency. So there could be ophthalmologic findings. So ophthalmic examination is very, very important. And remember, dear students, phrenoderma is not just due to the vitamin A deficiency. It could be due to B complex deficiency, vitamin C, vitamin E, and also essential fatty acids. But any day, vitamin A deficiency is very important. And you can see the complication associated with severe vitamin A deficiency is blindness. And also beta spot xerosis. Also, I hope you all know. Stable hypopigmented patch is present since birth. Now the 20-year-old person is coming with a lesion which is there since the birth. So there is no change in the color or size of the lesion, hypopigmented lesion, but it's not depigmented lesion. Woods lamp is showing a dull white accentuation, dioscopy is negative. So with all these clues, So first clue, since birth is going to help us to rule out the infection, indeterminate leprosy, which will not be from the birth. Vitiligo is also acquired. Depigmentary disorder, it will not be there since birth. And also, it is not depigmented, which is mentioned in the question. So it cannot be vitiligo. And we are left out with nevus depigmentosus and nevus anemicus. Remember, dear students, this Wood's lamp examination of dull white accentuation is going to be seen in nevus depigmentosus. And also, the dioscopy, which is mentioned as negative, is also one of the features of nevus depigmentosus. So answer is going to be option B. So why is it not nevus anemicus? So check out this table, dear student. Nevus anemicus is going to have no accentuation as it is mentioned in the question, and also it is going to show positive dioscopy where there is going to be blending of the lesion with the surrounding skin. So these two are going to help in differentiating and identifying the answer as nevus depigmentosus. I hope it is clear. And this question is a very much repeated topic. Freckling is present or sun exposed photosensitive areas. These freckles are present even on other body areas, and also biopsy confirmed other BCCs which are present in this patient. No family history of immunodeficiency whatsoever. DNA repair pathway, which of the following is associated with the patient's condition? Nucleotide excision repair. The diagnosis is xeroderma pigmentosum. Very, very important topic from dermatology and also biochemistry integration, I can say. So yeah, these are all my links. They are available in the comments and also description. You can check out and you can chill out. The next question is recurrent oral ulcer, frequent respiratory tract infections. Most important clues, reduced ADA activity. By this time, I hope you have answered it as SCID. Next question, dry eyes, dry mouth, difficulties swallowing, dry food, vaginal dryness is there. There is dryness everywhere, dental caries are there. So most specific for the patient's condition, I hope all of you know this answer. It is Sjogren syndrome, so anti-Rolla antibodies. Next is this question, abattoir, slaughterhouse. So this we can say recent FMGE question. Similar question came, there was a HR forest going history was there. The answer there was scrub typhus, and the treatment was doxycycline. So here the another type of question. So slaughterhouse, painless pustule that progressed into ulcer, malignant pustule is being described, and most importantly it is showing positive McFadden's reaction. So what is the organism? It is going to be option D, bacillus anthracis. Next is the low impact fractures. There are perifollicular hemorrhages, most likely corkscrew hairs would also be there. Dry hair is scaly skin, lusterless hair. So there is a problem with the nutrition. So most likely we should think of a diagnosis of vitamin C deficiency, that is scurvy. And among the given options, it's going to be prolyl hydroxylase, which is going to be functionally impaired in this patient. Next question is the straightforward question, most common with the associated base of the tongue squamous cell carcinoma. It is better going to be the human papilloma virus. If you feel anything was else asked in the question or something was different in the options, you can put your suggestions in the comment section. And this is showing a bronzing of the skin, hyperpigmentation of the skin, and there is basically primary adrenal insufficiency pointing towards Addison's disease. So what is the reason for this pigmentation? It is ACTH. So there was a question related to the venous varicose veins, venous ulcer. So I have not got the question. If you have got it, please put that in the comment section. So these are all my important groups. You can join the Dermatology Academic groups. Their links are there in the comments in the description. And Diet, Dhan Gyan, and also Dharma Gyan, I like to also make videos on them. So I will link the links in the comments. You can join them. And my suggestion would be chill out. If you have given the NEETPG 2025 exam just now, watch any of these movies to just relax, or pray to God that you are going to get a great result. But if you are having any doubts, any suggestions, you can reach me out on WhatsApp number and put whatever queries you have. Thank you so much. I hope this video was helpful. If so, please hit that like button. Do subscribe to this channel so that you are going to get such awesome dermatology related videos on a regular basis. So chillax, relax. You have done the great work. You are going to get the great results. All the very best. Happy learning. Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam Sarve Jana Sukhina Bhavantu. Dr. Maddineni Srinivas signing off.